Hi everybody, it's Keisha. Today we are going to be gold foiling my Archer and Olive notebook here. I've been really enjoying this for bullet journaling. I will even give you a little show and tell of how I set it up for next week. Spoiler alert, this is Sarah Marie's recent mystery kit. I just got mine in the mail yesterday. I was so excited to use it that I have already used it. So I'm going to be showing you that in case you haven't gotten yours yet. But this is what week 10 looks like for me. I've decided to lay it out this way using a vertical kit. And then I use the Daily Duo headers for every day of the week. So I've been having a lot of fun playing around with Sarah Marie stickers and bullet journaling in this notebook. I have never been more productive than I have in a bullet journal. So I used to bullet journal back in 2017, stopped for a while, got really into all the planner things and tried everything out, and we've come full circle and I'm back in a bullet journal again. Anyway, back to foiling my cover. So I wanted to just, I don't know, play around in here. I'm gonna be gold foiling because the image of the fox is also gold, so it'll just match. And I'm just going to be doing some doodling. So I think I'll probably put the year down at the bottom, like 2020. I don't know. Or my name. I haven't really decided. And this is not going to be perfect, so I'm just going to have to be happy with however it turns out. So let's be brave together and test it. I got this B5 notebook in the Archer and Olive mystery sale. It's something that they have kind of running all the time. You get to test out the notebook, the pen, and you get some washi tape in the mystery kit. I'm trying to find a piece of tape to tape this up. So I had never had an Archer and Olive before, and I wanted to try the pens, but I didn't want to buy a whole pack. You can buy them individually now, I think, but at the time you couldn't. So I wanted to try the notebook and the pens without investing a whole lot of money, and the mystery mystery purchase. I don't know what they're called. I should really go look that up. Just seemed like the better option to get everything that I wanted at an affordable price. So I'm gonna start doodling over here. I think I'm just gonna do some like leaves or florals or my name. Should I do my name? I think we'll start with my name because why not? And we will just see how well this goes. So I'm going to be using my foil quill that I got earlier in the year. And this is a cloth cover, in case you were wondering. I'm just sort of taping it down to make sure that the foil is secure. Ooh, this is going to be a challenge. Let's see. You want to make sure your foil is taut while you're doing this. And it is just not sticking for me. So let's see what we can do here. I have a clip. Doesn't really hold it that great, but I think what I'll do is I'll hold it with my hand here and then just kind of hope that clip stays there. And we're just gonna kind of go for it. So last time I foiled on a cloth cover, it didn't turn out so well, but I think it was because the foil, I use a different color foil. Here we go. I used a pink foil last time I did this, and the pink foil didn't really stay well on the cloth cover, but gold seems to be better on other things, so we will just try. Being pretty brave about this, I didn't like sketch or plan this out at all. Well, gold seems to be better on this notebook than when I tried it last time. Oh my gosh. Okay, big reveal. Oh, let's dot the I there. All right, it's not too noticeable, I think. You see that? So I'm pretty sure if I didn't like that, I could rub that off as well. Oh, that's awesome. That's kind of cool. So I might even do something on the spine here. That's what I think I'll do next. I think what I'll do, this notebook is gonna get so dirty because I'm not very careful with my things when they're tumbling around in my bag with me all the time. I think I'm gonna do the year on the spine here. Oops, I already ripped off some gold foil with the washi. Let's see. Hardest part is like trying to keep it secure. So maybe we'll put it down at the bottom. The reason why I am doing this is because I'm about to get my Archer and Olive subscription box notebook in the mail and want to see if my ideas work. And if I like this, I might do this to my next Archer and Olive as well. I just don't feel too attached to this cover, since I didn't really get to pick it out, so I feel a little more comfortable experimenting and playing on it. So we'll just do 2021 on this spine, and I think I'm gonna really like how it'll turn out. It'll just be kind of messy. We're just gonna be okay with it. So this is the medium tip that you can buy of these. They come in three different size tips. I have the fine and the medium, and I don't have the bold. Whoops. That's gonna look weird. And if you haven't seen my initial video using these, oh gosh, I hope that ends up looking like a two and not like a weird Z. You want to write a little bit slower with these than you would with a normal pen or something, just so that the heat can pick up the foil and transfer properly onto your surface. But these are so fun. 2021. Ta-da! Oh, that is so cool. Oh man. Kind of wish I did a little bit more on the zero, but still really happy with that. I don't know why that reminds me of a yearbook or something, but yeah, there we go. What else could we do? We could go really crazy with this. I'm gonna do like a little flower over here or something, or a heart. What do you think? Let's try a little flower. I think the hardest part is like figuring out how to keep your foil paper straight while you're doing this, or like, sorry, secured rather, so that's not moving around all over the place. Cute. A little off center, but that's okay. Maybe my Instagram handle? I don't know. Is that too much? I'm just gonna stop there because I could probably go really crazy with it, but that turned out super cute. Do you guys use Archer and Olive? This is my first one. The paper is super thick. But yeah, anyway. Hope you enjoyed. Hope that was fun. And let me know what you want to see next, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.